Hi guys, welcome to my so-so studio. The chill girls are in the kitchen playing with the My Life Kitchen. Way too big for them, but they don't care. And guess what we're going to do? We're going to do some crafting. Some last minute or Christmas Eve crafting. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready, girls? We're ready. These empty capsules become this. Isn't it cool? Ornaments. We're going to take our capsules that normally are just thrown away or lost, and we're going to make some cool little My So-So ornaments. Isn't that cool? Look in there. Aren't you excited? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Say yes, I'm ready. Okay, so here we go. What we're gonna do is, if you are an LLL lover, you probably have tons of these capsules, right? So, what do you do with them when you're done with them? Do you leave them around? They just kind of pile up everywhere, like where you mostly do. So what we've done is, we are going to make ornaments with them. We're going to take these little capsules that normally just kind of pile up everywhere. There's a, you know, front and a back to them. Here's a little back. And we're going to make an ornament because this is our first year as My So-So Studios. We want to honor it with an LOL ornament since that's mostly what we collect. We don't always collect everything LOL. We do a lot of different dolls. That was our first doll. So our first series. And so we're going to actually make some ornaments out of these, which is really cool. I mean, there's a lot of cool, super things you can do with these. Please check out the videos that we're going to be coming, that are coming up, that you're going to see with these, because most of the time I hope that you're recycling them, because you know we're a Reclaim Studio. And if you're not recycling them or reclaiming them for something else, then try to figure out what it is that you would like to do them. These would make great planters, if you like to do herbs and things like that. So, you know, go online and just look up containers and you'll be able to find something. And always check out our channel because we always do super cool things with our packaging for our dolls. So here we go. We have several different LOL. That's the LOL surprise ones that I showed you. And here's the other LOL winter chill little capsules that come with the LOL. And this little cute little guy came in this one. So what we did was we took one of the charms from one of our previous videos, so please check that out. It's the link is up above where I talk about these charms. And I love this little lollipop. The stick came off, so I glued it back, and now our little friend is holding him. And I'm not gonna lie, I thought he was kind of creepy, this one, but Sonila loves him a lot. And evidently the little container, for those who collect, are meant to actually hold the little doll. And so we're going to use that with our capsule. So what we did was I hot glued the lollipop to him, the little charm, and made him go ahead and sit in the capsule like he's supposed to. And we are actually going to close this up. So I'm going to take it and close it up, encase them in there for our ornament, right? And normally I would take the little ornament piece and put it upside, you know, that, but he'll be upside down. So if you were just wanting to do like a snow globe sort of situation, then you could do that, and put, you know, a tree in here, like go get one of those miniature trees and stuff and put it in there and then do like that, and it'll fit perfectly for your little ornament. But because we're using him, and when we're done with our little ornament, it can hang on the tree or it can go back on its original little stand like it's supposed to. Give me a second to pop that in. And he can sit on the table. You know, the little ornament can sit on the table. So I didn't want to get rid of it. I want to show two different ways you could do it. So I didn't get rid of the stand for this one. Now, we've got him in this little stand. And what I've done is, because, you know, we reclaim. This is a lid from a bottle of oil. You can get any lid, but I just happened to have a bottle of oil that I was finished with. So I have a lid. And in our video for our store, and if you like to watch that video, the link is above and watch that video about our store. But I use this for our shelving, so I had plenty of it. and I took and hot glued it around the rim here and added a little bead. I had two beads, so I kind of lift up. Let me show you the two beads. So there's one bead and there's another bead I hot glue on top. And what I did was I laid the ribbon down first and then put a piece of hot glue in the middle and then press the bead down, the first bead, and then put a piece of hot glue on the first bead and put the second bead on top. And so now I have my hanger that I can actually, it'll be neatly be able to tie for my ornament. And so the last step for this, the next step for this is to add a little bit more decoration. Now, if you want to be able to get into this, then don't do this step so that you can be able to pop it off. But I'm not going to get back into this one. I'm going to leave it just like it is. And so what we're going to do is we're going to take and put some hot glue here and go ahead and hot glue around there for that. So we have our my so-so or our so-so pink is on there. So that's what we wanted to do for that. All right. So we have that glued down. I did it off camera because I have a tendency to burn myself when I do that. But it takes me a little while because I go really slow, so I can avoid that. So what I did was I took and I hot glued the put the glue all around the outside here and hot glued that all the way around till I get to the end, because remember, I want to be able to have that base. So I want to be sure I don't make a mistake and get in the way of the base. And now we're just going to cut that, and all the little things are everywhere. We're gonna cut that off. Gotcha. And just so that we can get everything else straight, we're gonna put that on there like that. Okay, so I realized that I forgot to add my glitter because I wanted some snow in there. So I wanted a little bit of snow glitter in there inside the globe, because it is like a snow globe. That was the tension of this little winter chill LOL capsule. And so I did go back in and put some snow in there, and it kind of gathers on the top. I don't know if you can see it, like on the top of the snow globe. I like that. You can always take in a dryer sheet and kind of rub the inside of this before you put the glitter, and it usually helps with it not sticking. So if you want to do that, you can. It doesn't bother me that it's kind of sticking on the snow globe. So I think that's pretty cool. So we have that. Now we've got our snow in there. And then, let's see if I can get really close. There's two little holes right here, right? I put a little bit of hot glue in those because the glitter was coming out. And also on the bottom, I put a little bit of glitter. If that's bothering you, you don't like it, you can always add some little stickers. So we can take and put some little stickers on there because the hot glue is transparent. But if you don't like it, you can decorate it, do some symmetry here, and put some little stickers on. We'll get one more. And to cover up the holes. So it does give it like a little winter vibe there. So that's pretty cool once you look at that. So we've got the little stickers to kind of cover the holes. Now we can put it on its base. Right? While we do this next part. So the next part we're going to take and actually intended this one. What I did was for the lid for this one, this one's going on this particular snow globe. I took a bead, and inside the bead I threaded it with the yarn, right? And poked a hole in the lid first and wrapped it through. So let me show you how I did that one. I don't know why sometimes I stutter. I don't know what that's about, but it's okay. It's okay. Oh, here's my little bead. And let me get my yarn. I dropped it on the floor, of course, as I knock around the screen. Look, everything's not perfect when you're videoing, so I'm gonna show you real. And what I did was I bent it in half. Sorry, I got my arm all in there. Took the bead and threaded it through the bead like so. So I've got it in the bead, and then I pulled it through, so I have my little loop, and then did a little slip knot. So I took it, pulled it through, and did a slip knot onto the bead, right? Then I took the bead and threaded it through the hole, right, and pulled it, and now I have my hanger for my ornament. So that's pretty cool. So again, this is thread, some yarn I had got from, or rib, I should start calling yarn. It's ribbon I had got from the dollar store at the end of the season. I think it was like 3 cents or something like that for a whole spool of it. It came in a spool like this, and they just were reducing it, I guess, for the holiday. I've never seen a dollar store do that before. And now we have our lid. So honestly, this project cost us pretty much nothing because we already had all these supplies. But if we had to say, I would say for the whole entire project is probably like maybe $2 or $3, including the glitter and everything, not including the ornament itself, because remember, that's from my LOL surprise. So if you want to include that, it's another $8. But still, remember, we're reclaiming this. Now we're going to take and we're just going to put hot glue just on the edges. And because of the weight of it, Gorilla Glue or Super Glue or any of those things like that. But I have this high, heavy duty hot glue that I'm using, and it usually holds pretty well. So, and then we'll just take and glue, center of that. And glue it down. And our ornament is ready. Alright, so what I have done is hot glued all the glue around on the inside of there. I've taken the glue, you saw me do that. And I let it sit for a minute. Like I said, if you wanted to, you can actually take Gorilla Glue, put it on there. Either way, you gotta let it sit. Hot glue, let it sit. Super glue, let it sit. And then your ornament is ready to hang. Look at that. Isn't that pretty? Look at it twirling. It's awesome. And on the top, I just took some super fine, it's called holographic glitter. So I had some, it's a little bit of holographic glitter, and put that in there. And that's what you're looking at on the top. So I just, honestly, I just used hot glue and put hot glue all around and then sprinkled it on and everything. And we have it there. And I think this is a total My So-So Studio ornament. Love this. And when we don't want to use the ornament, we just take it, maybe we want to just put it on the table, and we put it back on this little base. And we can even take our ribbon when we're not using it and tie it in a little bow. Like so. And that can sit really pretty on the table. Isn't that adorable? I really like this one. This is really cute. So again, we're taking our ornament, our capsule from our LOL surprise. LOL, it was the winter chill ones, the old one, but they still come out with all of them like this and this little small one. And we have now made it into a Christmas ornament. So this will make a great little Christmas Eve, quick little, I mean, literally it could take you about 5 minutes to do this. Craft that you can do with these. And for all those people who have bought a whole bunch of LOL for Christmas, now you actually have something to do with the containers. They don't just get wasted. We do have one more craft to do for our larger capsules. Girls, are you ready to do another one? Yes, Sophia, please do another one. Okay, so we'll do one more. All right, here we go. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this little one from our LOL glitters that we bought. And originally, you know, these are taken and you take them off and they have like a little stand inside of there that the LOL glitter surprise doll can go in. This is one of our little dolls. I love her. She's pink and black. And you pop that out, and there's a little stand in there, right? You can use those for the dolls, and they do come out, so the dolls can stand on their own. So we're just gonna actually pop that one out too. It takes me a second to, I haven't mastered how to get these out. You just yank on them. I can't remember how to get this one out. Of course, when I'm on camera, it's gonna take forever. There it is. Ha! I got you. I got you. So it does pop out, and I'm always pushing. I think it was a pop up on it and then pull it, but of course I tried to manhandle it. And now this little piece, you know, you can use them for the dolls, of course, because that's the intention. You can take them out. And now the doll, bend down so you can see her a little better. And the little doll can actually sit on the stand, which is the intention of these little stands, so the doll can stand up by themselves. But we're going to take that out, and we're actually going to use the inside of this to make another ornament. And we use the one, I love this one. It has like a iridescent, I don't know if you can, let me see if I can make it, there it is. See how it has that little halo right there? So that's going to look great when the lights from the Christmas tree hit it. And I want to use that one in particular. And then, of course, this pinkish one, because that's, you know, pink is our so-so color. And this is kind of pinkish orange color. And we're going to use that for it. So let me slide this over. And you can see, look at all those capsules. We have tons of those things, right? And I'm sure somebody else does. Again, we did the same thing with the lid. We took the lid and we took some ribbon around it, and I showed you before how I took the bead and everything for that particular one. And this one I love because you can do the same thing with the other little small one here, but we put a My So-So Studio picture. This is our little Christmas picture that we took with mask off. And I told Samaya, I said, Samaya, hold your breath. And that's what she did. She held her breath and we took the picture, but it's really cool. We took one with mask on and mask off. I printed off a picture that was in a circle, the same width as this one, added that in there and just kind of wedged it inside of it. And we're just going to take our outside one that I like and put it right on it together. Right? Is that really cool? You can see down inside of there, and it does, like I said, it's going to make a nice little glow on it. And if we want to, we could actually add some snow in here, but I'm going to leave that one alone with some snow. You just have to kind of line up the inside, make sure that's lined up. And we're going to put a little glitter around here, a little glitter ribbon on the outside. Of course, it's going to be pink, and add this one on to it, right? Because I like the little cap on that one. And we could add some little glitter, but we already have one with glitter, so I wanted to show you one that wasn't, because, you know, glitter is my favorite color, and I want to add some on there, but I'm going to do this one a little bit different to that one. Okay, so we have taken our ribbon that we got from the dollar store, and I just cut, you know, enough that was this wide and hot glued it right around the edge, right all the way to there, and took these little gems that I got from Michael's, probably like 30 cents or something, because I got them when they were reduced. And actually, I'm sorry, that was AC Moore.
There's no more AC Moore, you know, in my state anyway.
Okay, sorry. But anyway, it was from AC Moore. And put those on the outside here, which I thought was really cool and looked very divalicious. I probably can even put some more around here, but I'm not, because I had a bow and it looked like this originally. Here's my bow. And it looked like that originally. And I took the same little crystal that's on the outside, a little gem outside, and put it there. And we're going to put a little bow right here and add a little bit of blue, because blue is my other favorite color. And that's actually my birthstone blue right there. So we're going to put that there on the outside of it to kind of pizzazz up our ornament. So that little piece is going to go there. Got to add a little hot glue first. So let's put that down. Sorry, ornament. Yes, go off into ornament land. I'm gonna put a little glue, hot glue. I'm trying not to burn myself this time. I'm always really bad about that. And do our little spiral to make sure that we don't have too many webs. Let's use my arm. And I want to put it here. Hopefully for Christmas, Santa Claus is going to get me an overhead rig for my camera. Wouldn't that be awesome? Yeah, Santa, also known as Mr. Morocco. And now we have our cute little bow on there. Isn't that adorable? Yeah. Isn't that cool? You can see my ring light in there. Look at my ring light. It's okay because it's doing that little glare that I want to do when I actually put it on the Christmas tree. So now this, I think this is set long enough. Because remember I told you when you put the little lids on to make sure that you let it set. Aw, look. It's ready for the tree. There's Sanaa and I ready for the tree. I think I need to put 2020 on this because that's when we started our channel. And we hope that you guys are enjoying it. We do this just because I love to share art. I teach art and I do art with my grandchildren. And we started this channel just because of the pandemic and we couldn't go to Michael's and do the little summer of art. So I started a channel with Sanaa because she really is a awesome influencer and I wanted to encourage her. And whenever she can be with me again after pandemic, we're gonna try to do another little video with our mask on. We'll see how it works. Hopefully you can be able to hear us. And here's some ornaments. All right, I hope you enjoy this. Remember, you don't have to make them into ornaments. You could actually just take, like we did, take our picture, put it in it, and have a nice little picture inside of here that you can just put on the table for after. Do like a little winter one because these are meant to be winter. So, you know, cut it out, put the picture on the inside. You can have a cute little picture frame. Or you can do like we did here and take your little doll and do the same thing. You can have a little place for your doll afterwards. Please make sure that you're always art smart. Find your happy. And my so-so studio is out. Okay, here's our ornament. It is finished. You can see Sanaa and I inside of there. Isn't that cool? It's got a light reflecting off of it. That's going to be really awesome once we put it on the tree. And here is our other one. Isn't that cute? And this is on a stand, and we'll pop it off the stand. And we've got our little hanger. See if I can grab it for our tree. And then that will be ready for our tree. Isn't that awesome? Look. Girls, what do you think? Cute, right?
Yes, we love it. We love it.
Yeah, I know. It's really cute. You're busy cooking. What are you cooking in there? Oh, she's got some turkey in there. Oh, that's so cute. What are you doing? Just looking pretty? Oh, there's a little baby. Okay. Yeah. So, yeah, this is so awesome. Had to give you another sneak peek because I realized I didn't really show it that well on camera. So, yeah. Here it is. All done. Our LOL is on the back. It's upside down. But that's okay. Nobody's going to see that. Yeah. It's all right, and it's ready. Be sure to check out some more videos that we're gonna have for the new little line of LOL Surprise OMG. And we're gonna be using our cute little doll set from My Life to create some more cool videos for you guys. All right, say bye. Bye. Say bye. Bye. Say bye. Bye, and I don't know what she's doing. Say bye. Turn around. Stop cooking and say goodbye.
Bye.